What's up, everybody? You're checking out Hollywood Unlocked Uncensored. It's your girl, Melissa Ford, a.k.a. The Curve Queen.
And it's your boy, Giovanni Watson. Hold on.
So we are holding it down while Jason is out of town. He is filming the 12th or 13th season of Wild and Out.
Which he will be sure to remind you every fucking other sentence.
Okay. And yeah, so...
Can't get a man, get mad at a man with his credits, man. It's hard out here in these streets.
Okay, and so
<I love you.
laughs> we have a guest in the studio.
Yes, baby.
One of my close personal friends.
Tell
one
him.
Of my favorite people on this planet.
Trying to get closer.
The world famous comedian, Earthquake.
Yes! Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Gio, I know you're fanning out right
man,
now.
Oh, man, I'm supporting out, man. I've been watching his brother since I was back in Gary, Indiana, watching him on the original Comic View.
Yeah.
Well, thank you.
Man, I was like, shit. I was like 1920.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Man, it's an honor, bro.
Been getting it for a quarter of a century.
It's been a whole situation of never a bridesmaid, always a bride kind of thing for
yes.
you, yeah? But,
yes.
things, but things are changing.
But they're changing. I mean, you know, sometimes it ain't your turn, but I have always been on the sideline to smile like a lot of women who ain't had a man in their life and always being the bridesmaid and never the bride.
Mm-hmm.
But it wasn't because I wasn't qualified.
Just ain't that time.
Yeah, it wasn't your time, man. Right. And I live well, you know what
you
I mean?
You live really well. You said you live in Calabasas.
Yes, I do. Mm-hmm. And I live very well. So, you know, it all depends. But this year, having my own radio show that I'm bringing back. I used to be on WBLS, but now I'm on, starting July the 16th, you'll see me on XM 96, Kevin Hart's. I'm there daily.
LOL okay. Network, the flagship
yes.
show.
Oh, my God.
Yes.
Yes.
I will be there.
Yeah, don't be bashful.
No, I mean, because,
toot your horn. Just brush your shoulders.
No, you don't do that. It's best when they discovered it on their own.
Amen. Okay.
You
that's
see
true.
What I'm saying? I don't believe in that walking billboard.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? You going around and this, but first of all, that ain't why I do it.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I'm doing this now because I make enough money for me.
Mm-hmm.
I just don't make enough for my kids.
Right.
How old are your kids?
Old enough.
How many kids you got?
Man, listen, I got four, and I got all four of them together because we on our way to the Mexican border, and I'm going to tell them they from Guatemala so they can break this family up. And they ain't never got to worry about me
shit.
Talking about where they at and come look for them.
You preach
Let
to the
Let the
choir.
Government take them. You understand? It's a lot of kids. You can go on and put them in foster care.
I'm still
you
looking for some nothing. Other kids to claim my damn self. And
man,
I got one.
Listen.
Okay. Well, okay. So
four.
We. At this point, we usually do a weekend recap. So you just got off a plane and came straight here, which
yes.
I love you for. So what were you doing this weekend? You just came from Oakland and some spot dates?
I was performing at this comedy club called Tommy T's, mm-hmm. five sold-out shows. We had a good time.
Mm-hmm.
Hella Oakland, shout out. Love y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Light-skinned brothers doing well up there with one chocolate chip on the team.
Who was you out with?
Oh, I walk with everything that's DMV, man. I'm from Washington, D.C., so
mm-hmm.
all my teams, I believe. And then I put young, hungry comics to open up for me.
Wow.
Because I want to stay that. That's where you stay sharp.
Mm.
That's
you know, so you don't, you see some comedians that get at my level,
mm-hmm.
pick no names. They put these weak comedians up there. I go look for the strongest, youngest that's coming up and then put them on my show for it.
That's beautiful.
So it keeps me strong and also... You know, let the audience see who's next.
Who's next? So you're giving people an opportunity, and I believe in that. A lot of people don't like to do that these days.
Because they're ignorant to the fact that, you know, no matter what I tell people all the time, if you get rid of everybody that tells jokes, then there's just ain't going to be no more comedy because they ain't going to mean they're going to fuck with you.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
Right, right.
It ain't helping your ass right. none. So I like the competition. I just don't think you're better than me.
Mm.
So,
as you should not think
so
that.
So let's play.
I always say,
let's play.
I always say I'm only in competition with myself.
Yeah.
There.
Well, you're dealing with something that's subjective. So you shouldn't even let it be that competitive ever. Because first of all, what's funny to you, my brother, might not be funny to me.
Right.
Mm-hmm.
And it's always a joke that somebody's not going to find funny.
Mm-hmm.
You
right.
just hope none of all the motherfuckers don't show up that night. You know what I'm saying? That's what the key is.
Yeah.
So. Do your thing, man. You're a clown.
All right. Well, a lot of stuff has happened in the media and pop culture over the course of the last week since we last taped. But, Gio, you were actually performing at the BET Awards, which just aired last night, at one of the... Everyone's basically saying this was the best performance of the night. It was Meek Mill mm-hmm. and Miguel mm-hmm. Singing Stay Woke.
Mm-hmm.
And you were dancing. Yeah.
Well, not dancing. I was acting.
You're acting.
Yeah, Meek handpicked me. He said, I like that guy right there.
Really?
Yeah, come on.
Okay.
See, that's what I'm talking about.
All right. Well, no, but okay, me and Earthquake missed it. So yeah, what happened?
I had to sit in my headshot, my reel, acting reel. Basically, once again, shout out to Hi-Hat, Terrell Washington, Trina.
Describe the situation.
So the situation was I got a text saying, yo, what are you doing this weekend?
No. What were you doing on the stage? Let me get there. Okay, sorry.
What are you doing this weekend? I said nothing. He said, would you like to be a part of this groundbreaking performance with Meek Mill? I said, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Hadn't heard the song. We got into rehearsals. They started showing us the vision boards of what they're going to portray on stage. Mm-hmm. And we got there and we did the night of the performance, everybody, you ready? Like, yeah, we ready. And I didn't know how big this performance was going to be. Mm-hmm. It was so simple, but it was so impactful. Mm-hmm. It's basically just bringing these lyrics to this song to life. Mm-hmm. And it's basically, we're on the block in Philly. Mm-hmm. I play a drug dealer just out here loitering, and you see kids out there jump roping and playing and doing all these things. And a girl gets killed by a cop on stage. Mm-hmm. Mm. And one of the lyrics that Meek says is, how can I pledge allegiance to the flag when they're killing our dads? Mm. And, you know, we had to get clearance to put this flag over this dead girl's body on
really?
The floor. Yeah.
Wow.
You got to get all that type of shit clear. But the energy that was in there was crazy. You don't hear it watching TV, but being on stage, you hear the crowd's reaction. Mm-hmm. And it was amazing, man. And they are saying right now we have the best performance, and I'm happy and proud to be a part of that.
So he was talking, so his performance, he dedicated it to XXX Tentacion. Is that how you say it?
Tentacion. It means temptation in Spanish.
Okay. Yes. And also to Antoine Rose. Am I right?
Jimmy Wapo is a Philly.
Oh, the rapper.
There's another rapper, yes.
Okay.
Front and back. Yes, okay. He dedicated to that.
All right. Wow. Okay. Well, I mean,
you haven't seen it yet?
I saw bits and pieces. This is the first time I was really not invested in the BET Awards experience this time around. Yeah. I don't know honestly, I just had my own stuff going on.
I will
on.
Say this, outside of Meek Mill's and Miguel's performance,
the energy
together,
was a little meh.
J. Cole had a very amazing performance as well.
Yeah.
To Meditate. So yeah. I think those are the two performances that's definitely, you know, coinciding what's going on in America today, and people, you really need to watch it.
Okay, so what was your impression of Jamie Foxx? I mean, wait, Earthquake, did you see the awards?
No, I was working, child support and living in Calabasas. My first about to come, you know what I'm saying? So, no, I didn't watch it. But you know, it's BET, it will be back on 15 more times.
1,500
this week, so
more times.
I will catch it.
I will say this, Jamie, I love Jamie. I can't say nothing bad about him, man. But that nigga was lit.
He was drunk.
He was lit.
Okay.
He was lit.
Yeah.
I mean, he should be. Yeah. He hosting. Come on, man. What are you supposed to
say? The Oscars.
Thank you.
Exactly.
I mean, this is a man that got an Oscar.
Right. Yeah.
You think he's going to be all tied up for the BET Awards?
Right. I mean, just so funny because I know just being there and not just being there, like, I know, like, I could tell, like, yo, he ain't sticking to no script
right
now.
No. He was just ad-libbing
the
whole
thing. Doing his own thing, bringing people up on stage.
Michael B. Jordan and Donald Glover. So he asked Michael B. Jordan to recite the lyrics, or not the lyrics, the that line from Black Panther, where it was, bury me in the ocean with my ancestors who jumped from the ships because they knew death was better than bondage.
Mm.
And he seemed a little taken aback, like, you really want me to say this?
Yeah, I think he low-key couldn't... He had to make sure he could remember himself.
I think Michael B. Jordan is starting to see what it's like when you when you play a role that becomes so prolific and so ingrained in pop culture that people have a hard time separating you from, you know, Killmonger. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I bet you're getting tired of that shit too.
Yeah, I bet he's getting tired of
the
pussy.
I bet you look at a Black Panther, goddamn it. I mean, get one more goddamn question about these damn Panthers. I'm doing Creed 2 now.
Right.
The hell all about this black crowd? I done already spent that check. I don't know, he mad about, he like JJ.
I mean, but that's just,
that
comes with the territory, man. That movie is so, I mean, and they won best movie last night.
Duh.
Come on, man.
Like, what other movie was it going to go
to? Girl Trip. God damn it, that changed my life.
You changed your life?
Yeah, I ain't seen it yet, but I believe
Okay, well, some of the awards that went out last night were to Best Group Award was Migos. Does everybody concur
with that? Yeah, of course. They're like the modern day Beatles. Yeah.
Okay.
Are they?
I think Ray Sremmurd would disagree with you, but...
Damn, they are too. Damn, it's
no,
hard.
No, they have a song called Black Beatles.
Oh, well, yeah, but they're both great. But shout out to Migos. Jeez, they're fucking really humble, by the way.
Okay.
Surprisingly, I was shocked.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah.
Why are you shocked?
I mean, they're the biggest group in the world right now. And then just what they portray on TV, you would think that they would be assholes, but they're the nicest group of men I've ever met in my life.
Really?
Yeah, okay, they was cool. Very welcoming.
Dope. Yeah. Awesome. All right. Okay, well, Best Collaboration Award went to DJ Khaled featuring Rihanna and Bryson Tiller, Wild Thoughts.
And can DJ Khaled please get a babysitter? I mean, God damn. I understand you love your son, but shit. You ain't got a nanny now. God
yo,
damn.
Yo, Asad be with him in the club everywhere.
Damn, at the club. I mean, shit now. I mean, I'm getting tired of this shit. I know you love your son, but can this little motherfucker go play at the nursery? He don't supposed to be at the bar.
And he have his headphones
with
on
the everywhere. God damn.
God damn.
Now, my kids talking about, can I go? Fuck no, you can't go. No, go to Chuck E. Cheese when you're supposed to be. You're supposed to be in this grown ass BET Awards round blunts and shit. Come on, DJ Khaled. Now we know you love your son.
Yo, that shit.
Motherfucker don't supposed to be hanging with you like he your boy and shit. He 2 years old, man. Go get this motherfucker some little.
Some noun ladies.
Yeah, or some army men to play with or something. God damn it.
That's so funny.
Shouldn't he?
Okay.
Damn, I'm sorry.
He does need a babysitter, but
that nigga need a nanny.
The collaboration award. I'm sorry, that
I don't agree.
No, I who then what?
What was who was
over the, Wild Thoughts? That song was a monster.
Jay-Z
monster.
It was somebody else in that category.
Jay-Z.
I felt like should have won. Oh, Bruno Mars and Cardi B.
No, it wasn't. It wasn't out long enough. It just wasn't out long enough.
Well,
that
was
song.
Nominated.
That song dominated. It dominated for a full year. Okay, but Bruno Mars did win. He won Best Male R&B Pop Artist Award, I guess, for the album 24 Karat Magic.
Love that, man.
Agree. Agree. I love that album. Mm-hmm. It makes me so happy. Best Male Hip Hop Artist Award, Kendrick Lamar. Does everybody agree?
I concur.
Always.
Absolutely. Okay. Best Female Hip Hop Artist Award, Cardi B.
Absolutely. She deserves every ounce of that.
Yeah. Okay, Earthquake.
No. Nicki Minaj.
Really?
Nicki?
Yes.
You said Nicki or Necky?
God damn it, whatever.
So, but hold on 1 second. So you didn't get a chance to see her performance? Because I would.
No.
She was drunk too.
Okay. Because I saw snippets of her performance on the unicorn.
She
was on a unicorn.
God
but
damn,
then I
boy,
saw
you gotta
her.
Gotta love it.
But then
everything
I saw,
fake. I mean, knock Nicki off on a unicorn. That's a fantasy because that's nothing real. If you break her off on a unicorn, might as well keep everything fake. Way to go, Nicki.
It was a very aggressive performance.
She was lit.
It was, yeah.
Listen, like you said, it's the BET Awards.
She came ready.
She was lit.
Came to.
Come on, you know her exes is in the audience.
Oh, that's
and everything.
Yeah, and they, you know what's so you crazy? Know, here's the crazy part.
Nas ain't with her.
Here's how petty the BET Awards is. They had Nicki Minaj right in the front row, right? And then they had Nicki Minaj's and Meek Mill's perform dances together in the same tent.
Nice.
Like, that's crazy to me.
Yeah. Nice.
They're totally okay with the fuck shit.
Yeah,
totally
I'm
okay
telling
with the fuck
you.
Shit. Okay.
Got Meek there. He got out.
So, Video of the Year award went to Drake's God's Plan.
Oh, I didn't see that.
Yeah, went to God's Plan. And my peeps from Toronto, they directed that video.
Oh, yeah, they did a great job.
Yeah, God's Plan.
Love that
plan.
Video.
Best New Artist award was SZA. She got robbed for a Grammy. So, BET yes. decided to, you know, correct, you know, right the wrong. Thank God her voice, you know, her voice is back because she said that her vocal cords were permanently damaged, but thank God that they're not because we need more SZA in our
lives.
I
love her.
Best Actress Award, Tiffany Haddish, of course, because she's been everywhere. Do you agree? Do you believe in the hype that is Tiffany Haddish right now? Or do you feel like she's becoming oversaturated at this point?
She's like the acting version of Cardi B.
Hold on with... Oh, God, that's a major statement.
Yeah,
Earthquake?
That's her year.
No, I don't think so. I mean, Tiffany been doing this for a while. Y'all just coming around to Tiffany. I mean, she deserves all the accolades. Yeah, but what that I mean by that is about
this right, last year has been so prolific for her, like
yes,
Cardi.
Yes, yeah. And rightly so. I don't know Cardi's background because I'm not in the rap, but I do know Tiffany's, and she's been.
And she deserves it.
She's been in the trenches.
She's been in the trenches for a while. Mm-hmm. And I can't be more happier for my sister. To be quite honest with you, any female comedian, especially black female comedian.
Amen.
It's
because
tough.
It's the hardest thing in the world. We hard on our.
Yeah.
I mean, sexual harassment is real rampant in the profession of comedians.
So let me ask you this. This is really interesting considering you are now going to be the flagship show of LOL, which is Kevin Hart's network on Sirius.
Oh, right.
Right. Tori Hart is doing stand-up.
Yeah.
Have you been able to see any of her stand-up material? While they were married, you would be folly to think that he did not get inspiration from his wife because she's funny.
Yeah. True.
She's funny and she's cool as shit,
true.
You know?
And I know Tori and I know Kevin too. So mm-hmm. What's the point you're making for?
No, I'm asking if you've ever been able to see some of her stand-up material.
No, I haven't had a chance to see it yet. How is it?
I think she's good.
Okay. Would you support? Or do you feel like you could support based
no,
on
I
your?
No, I support. Me and Tori are friends, so I support her. Period.
Okay.
And she's doing that. It's going to be hard for her to coexist because of who her ex-husband is.
Mm-hmm. There's always going to be some kind of comparison.
I mean, mm-hmm. She didn't go back to her maiden name. Mm-hmm. She really wanted to separate herself career-wise. Mm-hmm. She'll go to her maiden names and take that journey.
Right.
She kept the heart. So the comparison
is always going
to
be there.
It's going to be there, heart to heart. Right. I mean, you just have no Tori Hart. That's Kevin Hart's ex-wife. Mm-hmm. And that's another thing. I never understand how these women do in Hollywood. Mm-hmm. Just sit here and get a divorce from these men, but never give up that last name.
Hold on one second here. Anna Mae Bullock.
You understand?
AKA Tina Turner. She was like, all I want is my name. He can keep the money. He can keep the royalties. He can keep all that shit. I don't give a fuck. I need my name because that's how people started to understand who I was. I cannot make a star out of Anna Mae Bullock. I'm a little too long in the tooth for that shit.
Like Anna Mae singing no nothing on the rest of them. Mm. Deion Sanders' wife.
Wait, who is his
Eddie
wife?
Eddie Murphy.
Nicole Murphy
is my friend, but she's still Murphy. I mean, we can go with Deion Sanders.
We don't know what Nicole Murphy's maiden name was.
We
don't know that
she still
girl.
Kept that Murphy.
What I'm saying, I don't have nothing against, but it just trips me out how they trash their significant other.
But keep the name.
But keep the name.
But the funny thing is that when it comes to the name, the whole thing about marriage is take my name. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Yeah, but if we break up and get divorced, get that shit
back. I got mine back. Yeah, get mine back. You're no longer a strong man.
Okay, no. Hold on.
Whoa.
The same argument could be made for football players whose identity is ensconced in that number on their back.
Right.
They will always be Michael Jordan, always be number 23.
Or 45.
Or whoever. You know what I'm saying? That number is a part of thy identity. You can't ask them to give that up after retirement.
Jordan's
always 23.
That's basketball.
And he put that work in for that number.
Nicole Murphy had five babies.
You just happen to have some good pussy.
But what having kids has to do as your occupation outside of us.
Listen,
being married.
Let me tell you something.
Let me tell you something. Whoa.
You squeeze something the size of a pineapple out that little pee hole
I'm
you
not,
guys got
I'm not
and
saying,
then holler.
I'm not saying that's not significant. But you still can do that with your mate name.
Yeah.
That's all I'm saying.
You know what? I'm going to have Nicole Murphy and Tori Hart up on the show to talk about why they kept their married names.
I would love to know that reason why.
True.
No, you would really like to just look at the two of them.
No, Tori, that's my sis. No, that's my sis.
Sorry, Tori.
Nicole, though?
Yeah.
I got a condom on right now.
Nicole is one of the nicest women in the world.
Mm-hmm. And she looked...
And she's beautiful. She's gorgeous. Been knowing her over 15 years.
Oh, shit. Damn, that's your damn friend.
I know Nicole.
And
always great to me. And as always.
Yes, I know she like younger men. So.
Yeah. Hulk, I mean, go Gio. Ahead and get her, man.
See, that's
my sister,
thank
man.
Thank you, bro.
That's my sister.
Because if Jason was here, or Melissa would be like, oh, you can't get
Earthquake,
Nicole.
You know
there
what?
Ain't such thing as a woman you can't get.
Thank you, man.
Listen to me.
I might have to separate
it's
the two of them.
It's not a woman on this earth you can't get.
I just had this conversation the other day. They said, I was like, yo, I think I'm going to pull Janet Jackson. Jason and Melissa said,
whoa.
I'm from Gary.
I wanted Jackson until she started messing with the paid bully goat. After she messed with Jermaine Dupri, that was a wrap. There's certain dudes you don't want to go behind, and Jermaine is one of them.
Okay. I still don't know how he pulled her.
Now, hold on.
Catching when they weep.
That was deep. That was deep.
This motherfucker right here.
Ooh.
Gio.
Ooh, that was deep.
Gio.
Huh?
Did I not correct myself and said, you go get Janet Jackson?
After 30 seconds of telling me I couldn't.
I'm not going to crush your dreams. That would be like me saying I'm going to go land Brad Pitt tomorrow.
But you could, though.
You could.
I might be able to see how I throw sisters.
Yeah.
And okay.
You don't even have just the quality of a woman that you are.
Oh, well, I appreciate you.
Don't have to worry about that, man. They flawless.
Thank you.
I don't look at it that way.
Okay, well, let's move on. So apparently one of the biggest moments that also happened at BET Awards, Gio, let me know if you caught this, is that
Nipsey Hussle smacked the shit out of somebody?
The what?
Oh, Nipsey Hussle smacking the shit out of somebody.
Yeah, I saw that on my
okay,
Instagram.
So, all right, we'll address that. Nipsey Hussle apparently smacked the shit out of
a BET Awards employee.
I don't really...
He went the shits.
That's not cool.
But did you see what he did to Nipsey?
No,
He disrespected him. I don't know what happened. I couldn't hear it.
See? You didn't
Nipsey
see
was crossing
either.
The street with something. It was a little altercation. The BET worker slapped some stuff out of Nipsey's hands.
That's okay, slappable.
I didn't see that.
Nipsey slapped the shit out of him.
Yeah.
Okay, you know what? We're going to skate right over that because nobody knows what the fuck really happened, so fuck it. You know what I'm saying?
I know somebody got the shit slapped out of them.
That part. That's all we do know is that somebody got the shit slapped out of them. Okay, but apparently Cardi B and Offset secretly married last year. And he announced this at the awards. When Migos won Best Group on Sunday, Offset said excitedly, I thank my wife, you should thank yours.
Yes, he did say that. I did catch that.
Yeah.
But now it's hitting me like, oh, shit.
Yeah.
At the time, it didn't hit me.
Yeah. And for all the women that got so hard on brothers like me and my brother right here for going to strip clubs, I told you all of them wasn't down there, wasn't dancers. It was some good women down there. Now look at all these strippers that are making more money than you with your clothes on.
So let me ask you guys a question. Okay?
You understand what I'm saying? Being all on me, what you doing there? I said, I told you there was some good women down there, some rappers down there, some lawyers down there. They just down there trying to go to college.
Wait, hold on.
But no, you ain't want to believe I was just down there for the buffet and sitting down here talking to the women.
Okay, so hold on. Let me just state a little fact. Apparently, their marriage certificate was filed in Fulton County, Georgia on September 20th, 2017. So they've been married for almost a year. So here's a question that I was going to ask during another conversation, you know, when we were going to do a topical show. But a lot of people have the misconception or the idea that just because you're a stripper, you're automatically a hoe. From the perspective of two men that love to go to strip clubs and enjoy talking to strippers.
First of all, I hate strip clubs. But I don't agree.
You date so many strippers, though.
I fuck them. I don't date them.
Why do you fuck them and not date them?
Because disrespectful.
See, exactly.
That's very disrespectful, bro.
Exactly.
But I will not let you talk to my beautiful sisters that's independent contractors that went on and trying to find a better way economical to flip their money that are frustrated rappers, poets, and reality show and everything, man. You ought to be ashamed
Listen,
of yourself.
Here's what it is, okay?
Come on.
I'm a very, what's mine is mine. I'm a very stingy motherfucker.
Ain't nothing wrong with it.
So I can't date a woman who every man or a lot of men could say, oh, I didn't see her tits or her ass or she didn't. I just can't. But I'll fuck them because there's no emotion attached.
Okay.
And I do agree with you. All strippers aren't hoes. A lot of those women are blessed with a beautiful body that can get them some fast cash to take care of their family or their self or their children. But they all have dreams or goals, but no,
listen,
all strippers aren't hoes.
Let me tell you something. I remember I was 20.
Hold on, before you finish, I'm sorry to cut you off.
No.
Because there has been a lot of strippers that I've tried to get at, and they wouldn't let me smash.
Good. good.
They made me like, yo, if you take, you can take me out. And that's how they gained and earned my respect.
Listen, being a former video vixen, video model, whatever the case is, and, you know, then graduating to calendars, et cetera, I always got the label, you know, regardless of what was going on in my bedroom, which was usually motherfucking nothing. You know what I'm saying? So I've never believed that your profession dictates what goes on in your personal life. What are you laughing about over there, motherfucker? What?
He just said.
We got a comedian in the house, so he's always going to find something funny about the shit we're talking about.
I just don't believe ain't nothing going down in your bed. Right.
Sometimes I have some very dry periods.
I believe that.
And not my crotch, just in terms of traffic.
There's some heat in that motherfucker. I'm just telling you right now. Blessing.
Continue on, Melissa.
Yes, I'm sorry.
Yeah. Yeah, no, I'm just saying, like, I've never really understood why people equate, you know, your promiscuity with your profession, just because, you know, I remember when I was 20 years old and I didn't have a job.
Oh, you was out here fucking.
Nah, nigga.
Damn, I wish I could have caught her at that. Told you gotta catch them when they weak. When they going through the periods, man. I swear to God. Melissa, finish.
Well, I was 20 and I was unemployed and I didn't know what I was gonna do.
That's what I needed to find.
And a friend of mine who was a guy, he was like, and my middle name is Savannah. He was like, yo, Savvy, just go strip. He was like, you're gonna make a boatload of fucking cash. And I was like, oh, I can't. I'm so like uncomfortable with nudity. He was like, just walk around your house naked, get used to it, and then get up on that fucking pole.
Damn, that's a great. Did you get on it?
No, I couldn't. I was uncomfortable walking around my own house naked. Now I'm not. So, my neighbors get a whole show whenever I'm putting on lotion and shit in the kitchen. But that's a whole other story. Just saying.
I wish I could see his eyes.
Well, I gotta move over there.
You know what? I stripped for a little bit. Back in Chicago, this club called Club 7. I was 19 and I had a 4-year-old daughter. It's right in between my professional dance career. I was stripping.
Okay, so let me ask a question. Did you put a rubber band at the base of your dick?
Yes.
Wow, that shit's true. Okay.
Yeah.
The fuck you do that for?
Keep my shit.
You're gonna kill yourself. Yeah, man. Have put a rubber band.
A blood clot.
Man, and run my fucking pass the fuck out.
It kept me up. It kept me up.
So basically what they do is they kind of fluff their dick, you know, get it hard and shit like that, put the rubber band on the base and it keeps all the blood in their dick so it stays hard. Yeah. No woman wants to see a nigga on a stage with a flaccid penis. Dick.
I knew she was going to say flaccid.
Well, there got to be another way than...
No, that's it. How do you think I know about the rubber band trick? Yeah. It is a stripper thing. See? I used to date a male stripper. Mm-hmm. He had more thongs than I did, and that's why I had to end it.
I definitely didn't dance no fucking thongs. I had on like some little man shirt.
Bitch, bye. You're lying.
I'm dead ass serious.
What was the club called?
Club 7.
Club 7?
You want to know?
Can anybody find that fucking footage? Find proof?
I came up on a new face, Amateur 99. I did like a month. Just a month. A clean month. And I made a lot of money.
Oh, yeah.
My stage name was Cornbread.
Mine's would have been Stretch Mark. Coming on out, Stretch Mark. Don't hate, niggas.
I'm serious, though.
I'm the nigga your woman really fucking with.
That nigga said my name would have been Stretch Mark.
What would your name have been, Melissa?
Come on, boo.
Oh, God. I just probably would have used my middle name and Savvy. Or Savannah.
That's a sexy ass name.
Yes, it is. I probably would have just come into
tipped
the stage.
You all night long.
Savannah.
That nigga says, you
know?
Stretch Mark.
And you know what I would have come out? Have you ever seen, I know you know, he might be too young for this shit, but remember the Asti Spumante commercials with the lady with the top hat and like the penguin tails and stuff like that?
I remember that
and
commercial.
And the garters. Yes. I would have come out just like that.
But you can't dance, though.
Been gone.
Fuck you.
Melissa, you cannot dance.
I might not be able to do choreography. No.
Maybe
ass.
When you drunk, you could probably do a little something, but I've never seen you do that.
So hold on.
You're going to have to learn to pop it if you're going to get my 10. How about white strippers can't get no money from me? Oh, Johnny was a bad boy. I don't want this mythological bullshit you're doing. Let me see your ovaries. Pop this motherfucker, man. You trying to get some dollars up in this motherfucker. Bend over.
How are you going to say I can't dance if you've never even actually seen me dance?
From the way you curse.
What? From the way I curse?
Yeah.
Yeah, you do curse like a white girl.
Yeah.
I'm half white. I mean,
but that's what I'm just saying. Canada. You go to your white side.
I believe I believe there's another side.
Oh, there is another side. Did you see my Instagram story this weekend with the handcuffs and leg irons and shit? Oh,
God,
you missed
damn
that.
It. Where's my phone?
You missed that. Right. Shit. I left them on the bed in the hotel room, and I came back, and the turndown service had happened, and she had laid them out on the table underneath. Ooh. Underneath.
What? Damn it, I gotta catch it when she weak.
You fuck you. So you go in the hotel rooms to get it in?
What? Huh?
Do you?
Okay, anyway.
Ain't
so,
nothing here.
Listen, let me say, I know, I said it was in my story, I not mean, my feed. Oh. No, it's gone. It was last week.
Oh, wait,
week.
This got us looking and shit?
It's...
Fuck, I thought we was about to see you and shit. I'm ready to go home.
Okay,
man.
So...
Got me all listen, juiced okay. up over here. I think I'm going to see some handcuffs and shit.
Juiced let me up. Say, okay, look. So, Oprah has hit a... Do you need some deodorant?
I do need some deodorant. I'm not going to lie.
I know your ass just crawled right out of bed when I called
no,
your ass.
No, I took a shower. I just forgot to put on deodorant.
I'm good.
Come on. Continue on.
All right. Well, Oprah has hit a new milestone. We are fans of Oprah. Jason loves her. Mm-hmm. But she has been placed on the Bloomberg list. I didn't know that that was something to achieve, but, you know, whatever. Her fortune hit a record $4 billion to make her the first black female entrepreneur on the Bloomberg Billionaires Index, a ranking of the world's 500 richest people. Puts the last interview that we just had in context. But he did say that she is in that category of, like, wealthy people. She's at 494, just behind Mark Cuban and Ross Perot. And she can largely thank the performance of Weight Watchers International for this latest marker. Her fortune increased by $427 million this year as the company's share price has more than doubled. Okay, so folks, here is a little lesson in wealth, okay? So when you are, is learning the stock market and learning about market shares and learning about investing in the shares that a company has. That is something that we need to learn a little bit more about just in terms of investment. Not investing in this app or investing in just like the shit that gets all the attention. Do a little bit of homework.
Fuck that. We got to learn how Stedman getting down. Fuck that. Find you a good damn stock.
That's
like
the weirdest goddamn couple ever. It's like, are they together? Are they not together? Are they fucking? Are they not fucking?
How about this? Oprah's so rich, she don't got to decide what they doing, and he's going to stick around anyways, because when a woman...
So you think she's taking care of him?
It doesn't even... Yeah. No. Let me correct that. Stedman does not need to be taken care of, okay? He has money on his own, but Oprah is wealthy beyond belief. Like, there is...
I'll date the fuck out of
her. See that
bullshit?
What?
Let me tell you right now. If Stedman was a female and Oprah was a male, it'd be pressure all on him. Uh-huh. How you staying with him? Why ain't he married him? I just using you. Uh-huh. You don't hear no man's talking about Stedman being used.
Yeah.
We look up to Stedman. Way to go.
I'm not even fucking.
I'm pretty.
You understand?
How do you know what goes
know
on in their
fact,
bedroom?
Stedman's old potato head looking ass is not in that slave pussy. He's not in there.
You know what? I don't know. I think he might get down with the get down.
Well, I
wouldn't even care.
Yeah.
I mean, really. I mean, you got $4 billion chick. I'm straight.
Did you guys ever hear the rumor that Jamie Foxx and Oprah dated?
I think he smashed.
No.
Yeah.
That was all over the place.
I'm going to talk to Jamie this evening.
Find out for us.
Man, you hit Oprah and left? I'm looking at you in a different kind of way, brother.
Stupid motherfucker.
I mean, $4 billion.
Okay, shit. Well, let's talk about some marriage that has hit the skins and it's related to money. Tisha Campbell and Dwayne Martin.
Man,
are they friends of mine.
Friends of yours.
I saw
okay.
him at Michael Blackson's housewarming. That shit broke my heart.
Right, okay. Well,
why?
I hate to see
they
people
were together
get divorced.
For a long time. Like, 19 years or something
says
like that?
To death do you part. And
the only reason why, listen to me. People only stay together right now because you need their half on the rent. That's why rich people don't stay together. Because you don't need their half for your standard
damn,
of living.
Damn, that's kind
of
deep.
You understand what I'm saying? So, if everybody was financially secure, divorce would be about 95%. A lot of motherfuckers stay together because they need their half to sustain their standard of living.
Or it's cheaper to keep her.
Same thing, but I'm saying.
Keep it a keeper.
That's the same thing.
So but love just
that's
don't
That's
clearly
a
no
saying
more.
You guys use a lot.
I mean, you just, God damn it. I'm just, we done did it.
I think because, you know.
I mean, you don't even like being around your brother, then he's your blood.
That's true.
I mean, your mother, your father.
I just hate to see people get, divorced. Like, when I go to Zen Lounge, I'm used to seeing them both together.
Oh, my God. And I love her. Like, she just tears the fucking stage up. But she's accusing her estranged husband of hiding their money during their marriage, and she wants him to pay for that. So he is a sports agent.
Yes, he is. Yes.
Dwayne Martin?
Yeah.
He's been there for a long time.
Yeah, he is a sports agency. And so she feels like he's been hiding money for a significant amount of time, and she wants to know exactly just how much. She's asked the judge to take action against Dwayne for stashing cash. And they were married for 20 years, but now they're estranged.
It's going to get ugly.
Yeah, she filed for divorce back in February.
Sequel's going to come out what really happened on Martin.
You know what's interesting is they separated in December 6, 2016, but I was at Zen Lounge. Shit, when was I there?
When would
it must have been like, no, it must have been like around February or something like that.
And I
was sitting with Jeff Friday, same table as Jeff Friday and him and Dwayne Martin, and she was on the stage, and then they conversed afterwards. It was just, it's
damn. I mean, they're actors.
That's okay, true. Well,
that's why I could never marry an actress. You never know when they're telling the truth.
That's the same thing. All my exes said the same shit about me.
Wow.
I love you with all my heart and sing.
God, the cynicism is I'm real just telling with you, man. You black ha, motherfuckers I mean, here in L.A.
You just right. can't.
All
mean,
of my exes
can't.
Said the same shit about
can't
me.
Can't tell
I never know when
the
to believe you.
Even believe you. You're a paid liar.
Oh, all right.
All your life, you've been just sitting around here, method acting, being somebody else. I just got one question. While you was out here rehearsing to be somebody else, who was working on you?
Shit.
Okay, well, here's a question for the two of you.
Come on.
Okay, do you believe in joint bank accounts while you're, during the course of your marriage? Ever?
I do.
No.
So even if you're together for 20, 30 years, no joint bank account.
I think you're supposed to have a joint bank account that both of y'all put the money in there for the bills that need to be paid.
Yeah, that's what I mean.
Okay.
This is our monthly expenses. I deposit it and do a wire transfer in there, and you pay everything that needs to be paid.
But my
money stays with.
But don't you feel like that is a very cynical attitude to have, to basically say, I don't really know if this is going to work out. You go into marriage saying, exactly, for better or for worse, sicker or for poor, till death do us part. But having separate bank accounts says, I don't really trust you, bitch. So
no,
I'm going to have my side shit.
You got individual toothbrushes. You let us bitch, you got your own toothbrush. Why can't I have my own account? The fuck out of here with that bullshit. Just like they say they don't believe in prenups. You gonna sign one fucking with me. That don't mean you love me. Hey, you got car insurance, don't you? Yeah, you don't plan on being no accident, do you?
Damn, that's
no,
deep.
But you do want to, if you do, you want to be covered.
He just
so
told,
if this shit don't work out, I want to be covered.
Right, you just changed
you
my whole perspective.
You understand what I'm saying? So that all that old bullshit, nah, we don't even want here.
You just changed my whole perspective.
It is, this money is for us to deal with our expenses that we have among each other. That does not mean because I have my own account that I do not love you.
Mm.
This is the money that I accumulated, and I'm making sure everything is paid for.
So question.
But you don't need to know what I'm getting from ABC.
So wait, let me ask you guys a question. Let me ask you guys a question, because I was just reading this online the other day. There was a guy who wrote into one of my favorite pages to follow, Derek Jackson. He's like a relationship kind of expert.
Right.
And the guy wrote in and he basically said that he had saved over the course of a certain amount of years, about $45,000. And then once he got married, his wife had put in So his wife had put in like $5,000 or whatever. One day he gets a notice from the bank. Would you all get, there might be a little too much testosterone in this fucking room. Okay.
No, go ahead.
Listen. Okay. So one day he gets a notice from the bank that the account has been cleaned out. And she took all of the money and paid off her student loans and didn't tell him. So his $45,000 that he'd accumulated before the marriage, she'd taken that plus her $5,000 and applied it to her student loans.
And paid off her student loans.
And so he basically was asking the question, what do I do? I'm feeling taken advantage of. I'm thinking about divorce. Tell me, what should I do?
And kill that bitch.
He might not be the person to ask.
Kill her
he
ass.
He does have a felony and a restraining order.
Wait, so, don't be putting my business out there.
You do it all the time. Shut the
they
fuck up.
They know I got a felony, not no restraining order.
Yes, they do.
And the only
you
thing
said
I got,
it.
I got a restraining order from killing that pussy.
Oh, God. Okay, whatever.
Boy, these motherfuckers be bragging on their dicks like shit. I swear.
His dick is on the internet.
He don't want to know that shit.
Damn sure don't.
Why are you telling this
man? What happened, man? How your dick get on the internet, though?
He put it there.
No, I didn't.
You put your dick on the internet.
My, somebody, a bitch.
How you let a bitch somebody, take a picture somebody, of your dick?
Somebody leaked my shit. I don't care, though.
But how you get pictures of your dick, though?
I be taking them shits.
And he sent it to a girl, and then she put it on the web.
Hell no, man. I know, bro.
But you know what? With all the comments from the girls, I ain't mad.
Man, fuck that. Oh, man. Come on, bro. You want to surprise her with her.
Listen.
Play it to them. Bye, y'all.
Can we go back to
okay.
what?
Okay. Okay, sorry.
About the $50,000 in it.
What would you guys do?
Yeah, well, she would need a restraining order on me.
Okay, so.
Because she taking 45 of my.
So the marriage would be over.
Oh yeah.
Okay.
Trust.
Yeah.
Gone.
Yeah.
Selfishness.
Yeah.
I worked hard to put this 45, and you're gonna take my 45 and your little pinsy ass five and pay off your student loan
and not leave me at least nothing.
Not even ask me. Not okay. Tell me. I have to learn this shit from Alert on Chase that I'm broke now.
Yeah.
Bitch, I choke the shit out of you. I swear to God. Man, you understand what
I'm saying? See, I told you, kill that bitch.
I ain't gonna kill her because ain't no woman on this earth.
I don't mean literally. I mean figuratively.
I know, I feel it. Well, okay. You know, I'm a literal type person. But okay. I'm just telling you, just like this, there's no motherfucking way. It'll be over. But see, I think, personally speaking, I had a problem with you. She done something like that before this, and you allow her to get away with it. For her to do that. Somewhere along the line, she supposed to know. If I did this shit, it's over.
Yeah.
Somewhere.
Listen, let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. I got a saying I live by. For all your motherfuckers asking why the fuck I ain't married right now.
Tell me, baby.
Because you wait long or you marry wrong. That's why.
Long and still marry wrong.
Nah, son. Nah, son. Let me tell you something. Because I'm not desperate. Here's the thing. Is okay. I love my own company. I really like my own company. So if somebody's gonna come into my life and literally be an accoutrement, or
that's
like
an accessory.
Okay, thank you. Because I've had to lift that shit up.
Or just if somebody comes into my life, it's somebody that I've really, really done my due diligence to think, are we compatible for the long term? You know what I'm saying? Because I really know who I am, and I know what I can and cannot deal with.
That's the key.
And I would be asking a whole lot of questions. I ain't letting shit slide. No, we're gonna talk about this motherfucking shit.
So we rich. It'd be cool for me to get you your own crib. Huh? I mean, because you need yourself. You know, you need your own time and shit. You know what I mean?
We talked about that. Yeah.
Yes to separate residences.
Married?
Yes. While married? I'm married.
Let me get this money up.
You crazy as fuck. Nah, I need to live in a house with my wife.
No. We absolutely spend time together, but we're going to have two different places. So if I need to like jet off and go somewhere and like get the fuck away from you because you're annoying the shit out of me, enjoy your time alone from me and I'm going to go and that does not mean I'm fucking. It really does not. Because if I chose you, I chose you for a reason. It's because I only want to fuck you. You know what I mean?
God damn it.
But it also means I acknowledge you're getting on my fucking nerves and I need some me time.
Which is human.
Exactly.
Well, nigga, that's why we have a mansion with 7 bedrooms. You go take your ass in the other West Wing.
No, get her out the place. I can still smell her. Let her go to her other crib so I can miss her, man.
Yes.
You miss her in the West Wing?
No.
In another
she
state.
Need to be off the grounds.
Yeah.
In another state?
Bye, bitch.
Yeah, go.
Melissa,
please.
Then you're not going to have a successful marriage.
Yes, you would.
You cannot be married and then have different residencies in different states.
No, hold on. Whoa. We have them together.
Yes.
Okay? So we live in...
Miami.
We live in D.C. And we live in L.A.
Yeah.
And so primary residence is in L.A. or D.C. And then we have our other place in L.A.
So if you get into a fight, you're just going to take a fucking flight to D.C.?
Not necessarily.
What's going to happen that much was like, I need to go to fucking D.C.
I feel like through communication and discussion, we can set up what our ground rules are.
True.
How we are going to live together and coincide together within this relationship. That's how I feel. Communication is key, you know?
And be honest.
Be brutally honest, which a lot of people are not able to do. So hold on.
I was about to be.
With me?
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead.
No. I got scared. I got so scared because I wanted to say it. But go ahead, continue on.
Say it, man.
No.
Come on, light skin, it's y'all turn. Stay strong.
No, continue on, Melissa.
Okay. We'll do this offline. I'm sorry. But we kind of have to wrap things up. And unfortunately, we're going to wrap things up on kind of a sad note. XXXTentacion's public funeral will be including an open casket viewing. You know, look.
That shit still hurts me.
Let me tell you something. It's the family's wishes. This is what they want. When my girlfriend Daisy from my reality show, Blood, Sweat, and Heels, passed away, I wanted to be as far away from her casket as possible. It was not open, but it was pink. And it was so her, and the services were beautiful. But I could not wrap my mind around the fact that my good friend, who was younger than me and full of life, was dead. And I stared at the casket like it was... it was something I could not go anywhere near. So, I mean, that's going to be, I don't know. I feel like we have like this really macabre, like fascination with death and being in need and having this need to see it and touch it and put our hands on it and feel it. And it's fucked up. And, you know, this leads me into the whole, you know, hashtag justice for Junior situation.
Oh, man, that broke
my
heart.
You saw what happened with the 15-year-old boy that happened in the Bronx?
15-year-old boy got stabbed to death.
I mean, you know what? When I watched, here's the thing, is I was out like last week. It was Friday night. And I had not heard what had happened at this point. So I was just watching somebody's feed and they included all the video. So I didn't know what I was watching
until
I saw what was happening. And I... can't unsee what I saw.
I can't unsee it. And the reason, because I have my daughter's 15.
It was.
And I can't even fathom or even get over the fact that it's all because of a mistaken identity.
Exactly.
That's the worst.
That they mistook him for somebody else. And apparently it's all related to some kind of sex tape that came out with one of the gangbangers, his sister. But apparently she was all for
the
fucking tape.
She was all for it.
You know what I'm saying? So, you know what? It doesn't even matter.
But
all that matters is that this beautiful angel lost his life at the hands of gang members. He was hacked to death. He had to walk himself to the hospital, died in the emergency room. Nobody helped him. Everybody was so preoccupied with recording the situation. You know, and it's just like, ask yourself what we have become as a collective society. When you pull out your cell phone and you see an altercation happening in the streets, drop your fucking phone and go help. Do something.
I mean,
you know
in
what
this
saying?
Situation.
Just learn to, just figure out what the concept of humanity actually fucking means these days. It's just, it's heartbreaking.
In this situation, it's sad to say, they use five grown-ass men, use two machetes, three knives, and the way you see them stabbing and hacking him in his video.
I didn't even
unless
know
it was a miracle. Yeah. There was no possible way he was going to survive that.
No.
He bled out. And what's even more sad is with X, the whole situation is this thing all happened in the same week.
Yeah, but no. But the month of June has been really, really hard. At first, it was Kate Spade's suicide. Then it was Anthony Bourdain's suicide. There's been the immigration issue with the kids being separated from their parents. And then, you know, X's death. And then this
Philly, Jimmy Wapo.
Jimmy Wapo, Antoine Rose in Pittsburgh. It's just, June was tough.
And this is my grandmother's month, birthday month.
This was a tough month. Like, can we do ourselves a favor and try and spread joy and spread happiness and post more stories about, you know, I don't know, just people just invested in goodwill and sharing, you know, the positives of life, because I need it. I don't know about you guys, but I need it.
So I've been having this conversation with my daughter now. It used to be like, okay, babe, have a good day. Love you. Now it's just, baby, be safe.
Yeah.
Yes, so and make good decisions.
So
Earthquake, do you have sons?
Yes, okay. Two of them.
Okay, and how old are they?
16, two, and I got two daughters.
How do you feel about your 16-year-old son, you know, a black man in these streets, and he's literally, you know, like, he's literally like target practice for fucking cops or gang members or whatever the case is?
He's a black father. All you can do is give him the best information you can and pray.
Do you worry every day?
Oh, I don't. I pray.
Okay.
I don't worry. I pray.
Okay.
The worry part of it, I just pray that he makes great decisions. And I hope the bad decision he does make doesn't cost him his life.
Amen.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
That's
the
freedom.
Only thing. Oh, it's freedom. Exactly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's the only thing you can do.
Right. Okay. Well, we're going to wrap things up. Gio is like already out the fucking door ripping up
the shit.
I mean,
because it still hurts me a lot, man.
I know. I know. It's going to stay with us for a really long time because we all watched the tapes and it was
heartbreaking.
It was the definition of heartbreaking. A lot of people have donated to the GoFundMe page. Cardi B donated like $8,000. Her goal was $15,000. 100,000. She's surpassed at she was I saw was 92,000 inside of 4 days. And you know, my heart breaks for his family, for his mom. Like, that was her angel. So, you know, I mean, prayers up for Junior. That's all that we can say. Thank you all for watching Hollywood Unlocked Uncensored. Earthquake, I love you so much for coming through in a pinch. It's such an honor for him to be in the seat.
Thank you for having me. And you owe me.
You owe Melissa.
I'm afraid to find out how he's going to cash in on this
chip. Please, put it on the record.
All right, y'all. Thank y'all.
Bye, everybody.